Hi guys, I'm just shading these roses in this Yoda design, and it's something I've come up with to make it more efficient. Right, so let's I'll explain what I'm going to do. It's not the greatest angle to view this. I can see it a lot kind of clearer, but it's the only way I can do it at the moment. So, alright, I'm going to tone it. I hate toning a coin before it's finished, but it's just not going to work otherwise. So I think. Just a little bit. Right, so you can see the lines. I've shaded. Oh, right, that'll explain it. And so I've shaded this part here, and so you can see that's a petal, and then that rolls under this section. So there's a shadow. And let's see one. This bit. Right. So this is another petal. That bit folds under there, but this bit goes behind here. So where I lean the graver out, it creates that shadow anyway, but I'm going to add the shade lines as well. The normal way to do it would be to come from this way, dive down, and there you see them make a little tapered line. In this situation, that's quite comfortable to do, but especially this is how I did this one. I'm gonna show you how I did that, the technique. So I actually came in the line where you end and come out of it, still creating the same effect because you've got that little ledge. You kind of cut the corner off, so you still make a nice tapered. If you look at them cuts, see they're all tapered. And also, it happened as well, I am actually doing, I'm leaning the graver over, and it's making another dimension in the cut as well. Like, if you imagine the steps on the Colosseum. So, let me, I did it on this, the cuts are actually angled as well, so it kind of gives the illusion that this kind of stacks. And it's still experimenting, but I can't see how that wouldn't help with the dimensional view, because there are some things in art which have been told that the viewer doesn't actually see the shading you did, but he knows that the drawing is impressive, or whatever term you want to use. So some things you do, no one will notice they're there, or no one will be able to point them out. Alright, so I'm doing that shading technique, just going in the line, so it's a lot more efficient, and you really make a nice tapered cut, and it's got that angle that. I'm going to exaggerate the cuts to see if this is. So like that, I'm subtly leaning the graver over, so can you see what I mean? The line will be slightly, the line that you're cutting has a plane, and the plane is leaning towards the kind of shape, the illusion you want to create. Let me just shade this leaf, and flower, sorry. So I wouldn't normally, right, so this is the kind of bulby part of the bulbous part of the flower, so that goes both ways. So I would normally shade this direction, but I'm going to do it the other way just to prove that, because you've got a nice groove to start from, you get placement better, because when you shade the other way, sometimes you kind of have to hover, and when you place the graver down, this it, you can't, you're not really committed so much, but you've made a little mark, so you need to get them. You need to get the placement right most of the time. Oh, let me just, this is another reason, right. If you're shading, I've noticed, right, let's shade this. I'll shade this, this is the easiest one for me to do, but it's going to be upside down. So it's that banner, and you've got to have shading rolling off the edge. So the way I do it, I leave a little kind of gap, so you've got that little round bit that comes round, and the shade lines, I'm going to fire all the information about shading, and you'll have to kind of play this back a few times to get them all right. So I'm doing the lean cut, so I'm leaning the graver, not kind of intentionally, back. Hang on, am I doing that the wrong way? No. So it kind of, those cuts give a dimension as well. Oh, right. So the point I was going to say is, kind of hold the graver flatter to the surface. When you're doing shading, you kind of hold the graver, if this is, right, if you imagine this is the surface of the metal, when you're doing normal shading, you've got the graver like this. So just the individual lines, when I did the outline of the Yoda, I'd have been holding the graver like that. When you come to shading, kind of sensation is, hold it quite flat to the surface. And I think what that does, you've got less of that hovering around. Like I mentioned, you have to place the graver, so you kind of, you're closer to the surface, and all your fingers, so very subtle, instead of like this, you're going to be like this, so you kind of, there's tiny kind of less movement, less chance of wobbling around. And what that does, you can progress quicker, and you have more control over the lines. You can do nice thin start lines, I find a bit easier. So like now, I've kind of, it's probably a subtle thing, but the sensation of squashing the graver to the surface of the coin, but not quite. Maybe it's peculiar to me, but I just thought, if I say it, and you might try it and say, oh yeah, I've kind of can do shading better, so that would be the trick. Because there must be some things in engraving that some engravers do, and they don't realise why they're doing it. So that's why I make these videos. Probably after a few months, I'll do it without thinking, and I wouldn't be able to explain what I'm doing. When you discover it, it's kind of fresh in your mind. So I'll just shade this bit the same same formula as I did the other one. Oh, slip there. You're doing coins, even though this is kind of flattened, it's still not that flat. And the changes in level are what cause you to slip sometimes. If this was flat, a flat surface of a knife or something, you're much less likely to slip. So that's doing that kind of technique, holding it flat to the surface, and you can see I can quickly go to the next shade line with accuracy. You've got to do the two. If you're accurate and you're slow, that's fine. If you're quick and you're not accurate, that's no good. And really you need to be efficient, because you want to put plenty of shade lines in, so if they take forever, you're less likely to do good shading. So I'm going to plan that, since discovering that kind of shading method that I'm talking about with the kind of facet of the cut, I'm going to do one of those doodle. Oh, that's showing up really well. So you can see it. See, the cuts have got an edge on them. So you can actually use that to effect. So I'm going to do one of them doodle pennies I do, really intricate, and try and use that effect as a design. This is a Steve Lindsay 123 degree graver. So sometimes, like that method I said, going in the cut and coming out, sometimes it's because the danger is, which I'm probably doing here, is you're gonna damage this edge. So this was a little bit steep. Some places that I can tell it wouldn't hurt, but. If you're new to engraving, you don't consider yourself artistic. Generally with shading, the shade lines head for the centre of a flower. So a lot of shading is kind of the centre of a point. So that's the thing to look for. Because when I used to start, you kind of, if you don't understand art or shading, I just used to do lines in all sorts of directions. So You need a kind of a guide while you're learning. So the centre, most of these, so that was heading in that direction. I could have turned them a bit there, they're heading, so they're all going in that direction. So same principle, I'm heading for the centre. See, I would have done a slightly different if nowadays, because I've got a bit more understanding, but that's a fiddly one. All right, so this leaf, so there's a leaf, so I'm going to use that coming out technique. Oh, that's bad. That was a slip. That'll need a bit of sand. Actually, it's not that bad. The more you're always going to slip, but the better you get, your slips aren't as disastrous. They get less and less. So most of them, that was actually a scratch. Most of the time when I slip, it's such a light slip that it's not really a scratch. It's kind of a burnish, and that little glass fibre brush would have took it away. But so what I'll just do is a 1500 superstone. So I'll just, all the engraving will still be there, but I'll go over everything. That was quite deep. Yeah. So when you start, you'll slip, and your slips will be disastrous. They'll be like gouges. You can always fix everything, but you slip, but the slips get less. And to be honest, I could have left that in, because with the naked eye you wouldn't see that, but I do it so it's fixed under the scope. And then so it's all there, just not that tea isn't that crisp. So and I'll mention it while I'm at it, I learnt something there as well, because even though I sanded all that area, it's this kind of still survived it, that edge, and it created a really nice effect. So you know, your mistakes, you do a thing that you wouldn't do if you didn't if it wasn't a mistake. You see what I mean? Right, that's it. I'm back to where I was before I slipped, so best not to slip, but it's not the end of the world. Right, this is where I slipped, doing this. Oh, and that's it, you know, slipping, that's probably what subtly happens as well. You slip and then you remember the situations where you're likely to slip and you kind of prepare. That's probably what it is. That's... So I didn't slip that time. Oh right, I forgot to tell you. So I was doing that, going in the cut and coming out for these leaves. So it creates a little tiny carved leaf. So the technique, right, I've just analysed it here. Right, so this is the ultimate technique. Normally you've got a line and you shade to the line. Right, so you've got a line, you shade to the line. This technique is you go in the line, in the groove of the line, and come out. Just for a, it helps in some ways with the kind of shading on that rose. I think you see, was that a little bit quicker, but they're not exactly the same, but they're kind of the same shape. But oh well, they look, yeah, I mean, yeah, they look the same on the camera. To me they look slightly different. So this little corner here, that would be really, let me see if I can get, see there's a little, this little gap there, I'll show you here, but you won't be able to see it while I engrave it, but there. So that would be really tricky to come up from this angle and go in, but much easier in this situation to do a shade line going in the groove and coming out. And like I said, so I'm coming all from the centre of the shadow and just, so I put four or five shade lines in there. I probably wouldn't have, not that I wouldn't have bothered, it would have been too tricky to do five lines from the other direction. So the idea is use both techniques. Don't think one is more important than the other. Oh yeah, and this this part I'm also doing a curved line. So to do a short curved line would be difficult the other way. Let me know if you've got a clue what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about, but I'm just formulating my own mind, and I'll probably come back to it. Right, that's it. I'll shade that one and show you. So it's got some nice dimension there. I'm just looking at myself. So it's got some nice shadows there. Oh, can't. Right, I always play around with shading techniques, so that's just toning it and just kind of rubbing it with a cloth. You can do it with your finger as well, just to get some highlights, but that's quite subtle. Right, I kind of always like it dark, but then again, right, I'll show you. So this is a glass fiber brush. Because it's a rose, it looked better darker, I think, but this, so it makes the lights really light, and then it stands out better. But I'm always making it look nice under the microscope, and it's not really right, that's it for this one, guys.